You might have heard about the Schrödinger's cat. To summarize it very briefly, it's a paradox in which, due to quantum mechanics, a cat inside a box could be both dead and alive at the same time. This thought experiment is confusing on its own, but probably even more so to computer scientists. Let me explain. When we think about computers, more specifically about computer logic, we think in binary. At its core, every decision a machine makes leads to a true or false conclusion. A zero or a one. Binary logic is so deeply ingrained in modern technology that it feels inevitable, almost natural. But binary is not the only way to build logic. In fact, there's a strong case to be made that two values don't always capture the complexity of certain situations, like in the case of the aforementioned cat. Sometimes a system needs a third option, not yes or no, but maybe. A few weeks ago, I made a video about the base-free number system. In the comments, a lot of you were asking for a deeper dive into ternary. That's why in this video, I'd like to focus specifically on ternary logic, which makes ternary computers feasible. It's a fascinating concept that could be just as important to the future of computing as binary logic has been to its past. And if you're a programmer, you might have already used free-valued logic without knowing it. I'll expand on that later in the video. Welcome to Codeolences, my name is Jakub, and if you are interested in alternative, little-known computer technologies, you are in the right place. There are more videos like this coming your way, so make sure to subscribe to not miss them. In the 19th century, English mathematician George Boole described the concept we know as Boolean algebra. His insight was that true or false statements could be treated like algebraic symbols and manipulated with basic operators. Boole defined three fundamental functions. Negation inverts the value of the variable. If x is equal to 1, then negated x is 0. If x is 0, then negated x is 1. Conjunction is a two-variable operator that yields 1 only if both variables x and y are equal to 1. If either of them is 0, the result is also 0. This is the AND operator. Finally, Boole defined disjunction. It yields 1 if at least one of the variables is 1. If both variables are 0, the result is 0. This is the OR operator. Believe it or not, you don't need anything else to build actual computers. Obviously, engineering a computer is still a very complex task, but with just these three operators, we can build systems that perform arithmetic on binary data and are able to store the results in memory. Boole's system was later discovered by Claude Shannon, who applied it to electrical switches. He turned a mathematical concept into a machine language, and that has led us through the digital revolution. But it also cemented a worldview. That truth comes in only two forms. Computers work with zeros and ones, and in a sense, this reaffirms the ancient philosophical principle that every proposition must be true or false. This idea, known as the law of the excluded middle, can be traced back to Aristotle. Aristotle stated, "For any proposition P, either P is true or its negation, negated P, is true. There is no middle ground." At first sight, this law seems intuitively obvious, and in many cases it works perfectly well. Either the coin shows heads, or it doesn't. Either you are taller than your friend, or you aren't. But on closer inspection, cracks in this logic become obvious. Statements about the future, for example, puzzled Aristotle himself. Consider this. There will be a sea battle tomorrow. At the moment you say it, is it true or is it false? The outcome hasn't happened yet, so assigning a truth value seems forced. These are what Aristotle called future contingent propositions. They expose limitations in a law that otherwise feels incontestable. It took Jan Łukasiewicz to formally address this challenge in the 20th century. Łukasiewicz was a Polish mathematician whose work focused on philosophical logic, mathematical logic, and the history of logic. He frequently collaborated with Alfred Tarski, another brilliant Polish mathematician whom you might know from the Banach-Tarski paradox, the one Vsauce made a really popular video about. In 1918, Łukasiewicz delivered a lecture at the University of Warsaw in which he declared a spiritual war upon all coercion that restricts man's free creative activity. He rejected Aristotle's law of the excluded middle, which restricted propositions to true or false, and instead proposed his own logic system. In 1920, Łukasiewicz formally introduced free-valued logic. In his system, a proposition could be true, false, or possible. This third value was a way of dealing with statements about the future and other indeterminate cases. In his logic, the law of the excluded middle no longer held universally. If a statement was possible but not yet resolved, P, or negated P, was not guaranteed to be true. It could remain indeterminate. In free-valued logic, true values can be represented in numerous ways, depending on the definition. But to keep this simple, we'll use abbreviations F, U, and T for false, unknown, and true. These map nicely onto balanced ternary notation, a base-free number system which uses the digits minus 1, 0, and plus 1. In this notation, minus 1 maps to false, 0 to unknown, and plus 1 to true. You'll see why this is useful in a moment. Just like George Boole, Łukasiewicz defined three basic operators from which all other functions can be derived: negation, disjunction, and conjunction. Negation is straightforward. If x is true, negated x is false. If x is false, negated x is true. And if x is unknown, negated x is also unknown. Conjunction, also known as the AND operator, is trickier. It follows the truth table you can see here, but it makes more sense if we use the balanced ternary representation and think of AND as the minimum function. In every case, the result of AND is equal to the operand with the smallest value. Plus 1 and minus 1 is minus 1, since minus 1 is smaller, and so on. Now that you see how truth values can be mapped to the balanced ternary notation, understanding the disjunction, also known as the OR operator, should be really easy. It follows the maximum function. The greater number dominates. So minus 1 or plus 1 equals plus 1, since plus 1 is greater than minus 1. Using just these three operators, we can define much more complex functions like XOR, which can be realized with two negations, two conjunctions, and a disjunction. But about those complex functions. In Boolean logic, given two operators, we have 2 to the power of 4, so 16 distinct binary operators, like AND, NAND, XOR, XNOR, and so on. Ternary logic has 3 to the power of 9, so 19,683 distinct operators. This makes it quite complex, but in reality, just like in binary logic, only the subset of functionally complete operators are used in practice. Functional completeness is a property that allows certain operators to build all other operators. In binary logic, both the NAND and NOR operators have that property. If you'd like to learn more about logic and digital circuits, you might want to check out Brilliant, the sponsor of today's video. Brilliant is a learning platform filled with hands-on, problem-solving courses crafted by a team of researchers, teachers, and professionals from Stanford, MIT, Google, and more. Brilliant helps build your critical thinking skills through problem-solving, not memorizing. In their brand new interactive course on digital circuits, you will learn everything you need to know to understand how binary computers work on the hardware level. You will go from learning about the basics of logic gates to designing arithmetic circuits, the kind of stuff you learn in university. Moreover, Brilliant's growing collection of programming courses is a great way to learn how to think like a programmer. To learn for free on Brilliant, go to brilliant.org/codolences, scan the QR code on screen, or click on the link in the description. Brilliant also offers you 20% off of an annual premium subscription, which gives you unlimited daily access to everything on Brilliant. Thanks to Brilliant for sponsoring this video. Łukasiewicz created a consistent logical system, which was later expanded by logician Stephen Colclean and contemporary philosopher Graham Priest. Once operators are defined, they can be implemented as physical logic gates and arithmetic circuits, which eventually means computers. In fact, almost 3 decades after Łukasiewicz published his system, Soviet engineers built the Setun computer, the world's first ternary computer. Setun used the balanced ternary digits minus 1, 0, and plus 1, and showed in practice that ternary architecture could work. I'm currently working on an in-depth video about the Setun project. It's going to be my biggest video yet, so make sure to subscribe to catch it when it's published. This is the best way to support my channel, since 99% of people watching my videos are still not subscribed. But back to the topic of this video. The motivation for implementing ternary logic might sound abstract, but it turns out to be very practical. If you're a programmer working with data, you may have already used it. In SQL, when you query data and encounter nulls, you're using free-valued logic whether you realize it or not. If you ask whether a column equals some value, but the column is null, the result is not true or false, but unknown. This unknown propagates through logical expressions. If we run the following SQL code, we can see how the logic operators act just as the three VL ones we talked about. The results show exactly what we've discussed and follows the minimum function, or follows the maximum function, and the empty spots represent null, the third value. Łukasiewicz called it possible, and Kleen later formalized it as unknown in his strong logic of indeterminacy. This choice makes sense. If databases forced everything into true or false, missing information would be arbitrarily treated as one or the other, leading to incorrect results. Instead, by embracing a third value, queries can represent the actual state of knowledge, that some data simply isn't available. And if you zoom out, it's hard to deny how natural three-valued logic feels. Our everyday reality is full of indeterminate states. Binary logic forces us into yes or no decisions, often prematurely. Three-valued logic gives us a better language to represent reality as it really is. Sometimes true, sometimes false, and sometimes simply unknown. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, you might also enjoy this next one that you see on the screen right now.